Rudy Pizzi here. As you may remember, in June 2016, the Marx Toy Museum closed its doors for good. Sort of. Here we are 2 years later, and Francis Turner, the owner and proprietor of the museum, has agreed to open it for a short period, coinciding with the Marx Toy Convention. We're going to go in and see what it looks like in the Marx Toy Museum 2 years after it's closed.
How's it going?
Going pretty good.
Even though the Marx Toy Museum closed its doors back in June 2016, the building is still there, and Francis Turner is still wheeling and dealing and managing his epic collection. It's comforting to know that these toys are still safe, although Francis has been selling some key pieces to eager and enthusiastic collectors across the country. Watching these beloved toys find new homes where they will be honored the way they deserve to be is a real treat. There was one toy that nobody thought Francis would part with. When American Pickers visited the Marx Toy Museum last year, Francis wouldn't even let Mike and Frank touch Big Loo.
Can we take Big Loo out of the cabinet? Nobody touches Big Loo.
That hilarious exchange even inspired a shirt, and we couldn't resist the chance to have Francis repeat it for our cameras.
Nobody touches Big Loo. Not nobody.
However, when we turned the corner to make our own pilgrimage to visit Big Loo, safely behind his glass wall, the iconic robot was not there. Everyone was asking about Big Loo, but Francis waited until we were all gathered together to tell us the whole story. This is the Ballad of Big Loo.
Welcome, welcome. Jason's not here this year. Sorry. He's the one that normally does the talking. But I got some very bad news to share with you people. Big Loo is not here any longer.
Left the building.
Big Loo has left the building.
Somebody touched
Big Loo. Mm-hmm. And I knew that all the time, that mm-hmm. something would happen. That's why I wrote, not nobody.
Yeah, mm-hmm. double negative.
Yeah. Yes, mm-hmm. So I covered myself there.
Right.
So, anybody want to know what happened to Big Loo?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. I'd
love to hear.
Well, about 3 weeks ago, I get this phone call from a guy from Fairfax, Virginia. And he wanted to buy Big Loo. And I said, I really don't want to sell Big Loo. And he kind of persisted, so I gave him a price. And he counter-offered with a lower price, of course. And I was telling him how special Big Loo was. And he said, well, what do you mean he's special? So I stayed up one night between 10 and 12 o'clock. I wrote this letter about Big Loo. And after I wrote it, I tore it up. I didn't like it. I said, that's no good. I'm going to rewrite it as if Big Loo is talking. Big Loo is going to tell him what is so special about it. So I stayed up to about 1:30 writing his letter, and I sent that to him. And then he made another counter offer to me, which I refused. But my wife, both times, said, Go sell. That's a lot of money. So I never. So he made a counter offer, and my wife said, nobody else is going to give you that much money for Big Loo. No. So I went back to him with my original price, and he said, I'll be there Saturday to pick him up.
You said, I should have asked for more.
Yeah, my wife said, yeah, you should have asked for more money. You sold him too cheap. So, he came here and picked up Big Loo, super nice guy. He walked in the building with a set of scales, a camera on the cord with a viewing thing. And he weighed Big Loo, and he weighed 9.2 pounds, right on the money. And he tried to stick the camera in, and he could only get it in a very short distance. He said, when he goes home, he'll have to put a smaller head on that. So he took that Big Loo home, him and his son and his daughter. Super nice guy. He's a dentist. So he came and took Big Loo away and put him with his Big Loos, his other five Big Loos.
Oh my god!
He has five other Big Loos in boxes.
Oh my god.
So he's gonna take over the world.
But none of them are sealed like my Big Loo was.
Right.
Oh my god.
He's raising a Big Loo army.
Yeah. He has a total of 12 Big Loos.
Exterminate.
12?
Because he never only bought my sealed Big Loo, he bought my other two Big Loos.
Did you call Homeland Security?
And he bought Torloo also.
Wow.
Wow.
Okay.
So, and I asked him, I said, you know, what made you pay that much money for that Big Loo?
Right.
He said, it was your ladder that you wrote.
Aww.
Aww. Good job.
Now, my letter is not done yet. It's still in the rough draft. I have to add the ending to Big Loo, but I'll read my letter to you.
All right.
I do have a bridge. I do have a bridge in Brooklyn for
here you. Here goes. No, this is only a rough draft, so don't be too critical.
How many pages is this? This?
Okay, Big Loo is saying.
Just a minute. Turn it around.
Spaced.
It's okay.
And
it's
most of this is actually really true. What really happened? Am I really special? My owner said that I am a very special Big Loo. Maybe he's correct, or maybe he is just a nut. What do you think? The box I came in read Giant Moon Robot. Hell, I didn't come from the moon. I was born in Erie, PA in 1963. Mr. Evernoff was one of my doctors that brought me into the world. Toy designer?
Right.
Yes.
And for some reason, he took me home to live with his wife, Marie, and his three children, Tim, Tom, and Becky. For 38 years, the Evernoff family was my family, and they took great care of me. Well, one day this guy named Francis Turner came to our house and he was looking at some toys. Francis didn't see me because I was hiding under a big blanket. That's true, he was. But I could see him. When he left that day, he took several of my friends with him, but he didn't take me. About 3 months later, this guy, Francis, came back again. This guy must have eyeballs in the back of his head, because when I peeked out from under the blanket, somehow he seen me. The next thing I know, I was taking a ride to West Virginia. The Evernoff family said they really hated to see me go, but thought that it was my best interest, because now I will be in a museum with all my other Marx friends.
Aww.
I think I'm gonna cry.
The ride to Moundsviille,
okay?
West Virginia, seemed long, but I really enjoyed looking out the window. But for some reason, Francis kept stopping and checking my seatbelt. That's true. When we arrived at the museum, Francis carried me in and placed me on a shelf. Hot dog. Right beside me was a couple of my friends from Erie, the Red Rocker and the Blue Bomber.
Rock and sock. Yes.
Well, for the next 16 years, I stayed in that same display case. It really was not that bad because thousands of people would pay to come in and look at me and my friends. Several of the people said that they grew up with my brother and my cousin. Then one day it all came to an end. The museum closed its doors for the next year. My friends and I sat in the dark. For the next year, my friends and I sat in the dark most of the time, but Mr. Turner would stop by every day to make sure we were safe. Then, after sitting in the dark for almost a year, these two guys named Mike and Frank came to the museum. They said something about being pickers. They were looking in display cabinets and trying to buy items from my owner. Oh no, where's my blanket? They walked up to the cabinet and I had nowhere to hide. They asked, how much for Big Loo? Francis said, $18,000. The little short guy said, can we touch him? Francis says, with no hesitation, nobody touches Big Loo. That's the way to tell them. I was so happy. Who would buy something that they could not even touch? Guess what? I am now famous. These two guys, Mike and Frank, are really cool guys. They have their own TV show, and I'm on an episode called Frank's Big Day. I am now famous and have been seen by millions of people. Also, my owner has made up shirts with my picture on them that reads, "Nobody touches Big Loo, not nobody." Now I think I understand what Francis was trying to tell me. Maybe I am really special. Now I'm going to continue it where the guy bought it and Big Loo goes home to see all his relations.
That's great.